The software for a stock control system is stored on a central computer. The computer uses random access memory, read-only memory, and a hard disk drive. The computer is a von Neumann model computer system with a central processing unit. State the purpose of RAM, ROM, and HDD in the central computer. Let's quickly describe what each of these three mean. Starting off with RAM, which stands for random access memory. RAM is one of the two main types of primary storage, and it stores programs and data that are currently in use. In other words, the programs that are currently running on your computer. The central processing unit, or the CPU, has direct access to RAM and loads instructions and data from the RAM in order to execute these programs. RAM is what we call volatile storage. This means that when we turn the computer off, in other words, we remove the power source from RAM, all the data that is currently being stored in RAM gets deleted. RAM is only able to store data as long as the computer remains on. The amount of RAM in our computer can be increased by adding more RAM components. The motherboard consists of a number of RAM sockets. Generally, it is either 2 or 4 sockets. These sockets can hold a single RAM stick. The more RAM sticks we install into these sockets, the larger our total RAM is. For this question, we only need to state the purpose of RAM, meaning we don't need to give any of these characteristics. So let's go ahead and write in that it stores data and programs currently in use. Next up, we'll look at read-only memory, otherwise known as ROM. ROM is mostly used to store the boot-up instructions of a computer, such as the bootstrap and the BIOS. When we switch the computer on, we use the data in the ROM to boot the computer up. ROM is called read-only memory since we don't normally change the data in ROM. The boot-up sequence of a computer is never going to change, so we don't need to modify the contents. ROM is known as non-volatile, meaning that even if we turn the computer off, it will permanently store the data it is holding. Again, we only need to state the purpose of ROM, so let's go ahead and write in the answer. Permanently stores boot-up instructions. Lastly, we're going to look at the hard disk drive, otherwise known as the HDD. The hard disk drive is part of secondary storage, which means that the CPU does not have direct access to the data stored within the hard drive. Secondary storage also means that data stored in the hard drive is going to be permanent, or to use the technical term, non-volatile. So we can say that the hard drive permanently stores software. For the CPU to run the software, it must first be loaded into the RAM, and then the instructions get loaded into the CPU. The hard drive has a very large capacity in comparison to ROM and RAM. Again, we only need to write the purpose of the hard drive, so let's go ahead and write in this answer. Permanently stores software and the operating system. And there we go, that is this question complete.